This is the house right here. So it's not even anything like it used to be.
Bob was like 15 going on 35, and I considered him probably more of a father than a boyfriend. He was somebody that really took care of me and loved me unconditionally and was kind and generous to me. And we got engaged at 19 and married at 20, and then we began our wonderful family.
The 60s was a whole change in the way people thought. It was the women's movement and the free press, and we were involved in everything. We created a free school. I had braids and went to Peacock Park on the weekends, and there were people playing music, and it was an amazing time. And when I look back, I am really pleased. I mean, I'm happy, excited to have lived in that time.
I know I'm a better person for being with her. She is probably the most unselfish person I've ever known. She, you know, volunteers her time, and she does for others, and she sets a high bar.
Be honest, the first time I saw her, I kind of was bitten by. His short hair, the eyes, I don't know. What do you know when you fall for someone? How can you tell? I don't know.
The same thing happened to me. The same, like...
Well, do you remember where you met?
Like, I think it was in Seaside Park. I think.
Okay.
I'm not sure, because we used to go there a lot.
Right, so was it like a picnic? And then you...
No,
you,
they were...
Just driving around?
Yeah, and with my sister and everybody.
Were you working at the movie theater?
She was seven. That was her 17th birthday party.
Whenever you're working, you have to feel it in the stomach.
When I first started coaching, I couldn't coach a rat to eat cheese. That's instinct in them, and I couldn't even get them there. That's how little I knew about making that next step. Should have played this game. I pulled out a list the other day. I have over 800 kids that I've been exposed to since 2004 by list, and some of their friends, and I met their parents and this. So I've been blessed that I have a fertile field back there, and that he gives me good health, and he gives me that girl that's been by me 47 years in 2 weeks, 47 years. How she's ever put up with me, I have no clue. But she's hung in there really good. And that's basically, in a nutshell, my life.
The reason that I wanted to tell my story was because I have no memories of my own childhood. My father died very suddenly when I was 9, and I guess it was so traumatic that I forgot everything that happened before that, and for a lot of the years after that. I spent many years trying to figure out what my life had been like. I went around and interviewed my relatives. I even went into deep therapy to see if I could uncover some memories, and I really never did, and I didn't learn very much more at all. So I did not want that to happen to my children, my grandchildren, generations to come. I wanted them, when they think of me, to know who I am and what my life was like and what our family life was like, so that they won't have all the questions that I had.
This was when I went to the beach, and it was, let's see what date this is, January 23rd. So this is the beginning sentence. Today begins my official first day as a full-time writer.
This is really interesting. when I go back and read it, it's bringing back all of those memories in a very powerful way, because I just didn't document the experience, but I documented what the experience meant to me.
Just pages and pages. Oh my God, this brings back memories. So that was about the Anne Frank exhibit. This was my horoscope. So sometimes when I do this, it's just exciting because I go back and get to see little pieces. This was the stationery that I created for the exhibit.
Now we have a very loving pair of sisters.
I think that they are already blessed with self-esteem. I think, especially for girls, the most important value and strength to pass along is high self-esteem.
I'm sure our daughters are going to be superstars. They already are, as far as I'm concerned. They'll bring much happiness to each other, to all of their families.
How would you want Sophia and Victoria to remember you?
A daddy who worked hard to provide them with everything that they needed and everything that made them happy.
And who loved them how much?
More than anyone else. Might make Mama jealous. I love them more than anyone else.
That's right.